What's up guys, it's Bobby here, and in today's video, I will show you how you can make a product finder quiz. Let's jump right in. It seems like at some point in 2020, I blinked and product finder quizzes became the new norm for online stores. Helix has a quiz to pick the best mattress for how you sleep. Brooks Running has a quiz that finds the best running shoes for your feet. And Curology lets you assemble your own product that fits your exact needs. If seeing these quizzes made you think, that is awesome, but I don't have the budget to freelance a developer to make something like that for me, don't worry. We will make a product finder quiz together in less than 10 minutes using all free tools. So without further ado, let's jump right in. So we're first going to log into Involve Me. This is the product finder quiz maker we'll be using today. They have over 200 templates that are editable, and you can slap your logo onto any of these. I'm going to be using this template, which is what diet is the best for you. If you like the design, you're all set to go, but if you'd like to change the fonts, colors, or background, simply click on design and then on project design. And in here, you can see that you can change the fonts, colors, and background. You can even make the background transparent, so if you decide to embed this on your website, it will blend right in. Once you're happy with the design, you can move on to the content. The easiest way to start is from the end. Making the quiz results page first will help you ask better questions because you have the end goal in mind. So to add a new outcome page, I will just click on the plus button on the right side of my screen. And then I will just give the outcome page a title and press on create. Here, as you can see, the design is already there, so I don't have to worry about editing that part. But I will just drag and drop a header in here. So the heading content element, I will just drag that onto the page. And here I can write in the result name. So I will also drag and drop a text element so I can describe the result. And I will also drag and drop a button element so I can link my product. I can also just sell the product directly on this page to remove any inconvenience for my customers. To do that, just drag and drop this credit card looking content element and select the payment options. A cool thing about product quizzes that nobody mentions is that they are still quizzes. They have the same benefits and stats as, let's say, a BuzzFeed style quiz. You can leverage product finder quizzes to create viral loops through social media sharing. People love sharing their quiz results, and they can do the same with this quiz as well. To set up custom results sharing, drag and drop the social share content element onto the page. And in settings, you can even let participants share their outcome by ticking this box, and then you can customize the sharing message as well as upload your own sharing image. If you want to know more about how you can make a BuzzFeed style quiz, here is a video that you can check out. So that completes the quiz results. Now let's see how we can make the questions. You can ask questions in many ways. Most people opt for multiple choice because you just drag, drop, and type. But you can also ask questions with images or GIFs. If you have too many answers to choose from, go for the drop-down select. After you've finished your questions, let's connect them to quiz results. Click the question, scroll down to map to outcome, and select the outcome you want that specific answer to be linked to. This is why it helps to name your outcome pages, because now you can see which answers are linked to which outcome. Let me show you how you can edit the outcome page title once you've already created a page. So just go over to the bottom of the screen and hover over one of the outcome pages. And then in the corner, you will see this pencil icon. You just click that, and here you can name your outcome page. That's how most people like to connect their questions to their outcomes. However, if you want to get really specific about what outcomes to show, you can add scores to your answers. Tick individual score and calculations, and now you can add more points to questions that are more important. Again, most of you won't need this, but if you do, now you know how. Once you're done with your quiz, just click on preview, and you can even see how it looks on different devices. If you're happy with the look, you can move on to the functionality. Click try it at the top of your screen, and here you will see how your audience will see your quiz. Take your quiz, pick different answers, and see what results you get. Once you're happy with your quiz, click on publish, and here is where you can set up custom emails. This is great when you're selling stuff directly in your quiz because you can send payment confirmations. We have a video all about payment confirmations, so check this video out if you want to learn more. Or you can just send quiz results, which we also have a video on, so go check it out. You can even have different emails for different outcomes. You can also connect your quiz to Google Analytics, Facebook Pixel, or Google Tag Manager here. And you can even send the data into your CRM or email system. You can set all of this up before you publish your quiz, or even after if you just need to have it live as soon as possible. Once your quiz is live, you'll get a custom link, an embed code, and even a unique QR code. You can use all of these to promote your quiz in whatever way works for you. On your website, in your emails, or on social media. Well, that was it for today's video. I really hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you're notified every time we post a new video. Thanks for watching. Bye.